Hello and welcome back. In the previous lecture, we've seen how to add ngCordova to our project. In this lecture, we'll look at the Cordova Camera plugin as wrapped by ngCordova. As usual, I've already created a new project called My Camera based on the blank template, and I've also added ngCordova as well. So we're all ready to start. Let's begin by creating a simple user interface that allows us to take a picture and display that as an image. So I'm going to create a list as usual with a type of card to display the image, and we can have a single row, so a class of item, and here we can simply display an image. So image and ng-source, this will be our picture, so it will be something like picture URL that we will add to the scope. In fact, we can create a controller straight away, so let's add ng-controller, and we can call this camera controller, and then we can go to our JavaScript code and add a controller, so app.controller, and I've called this camera controller, and then pass a function that uses the scope service. And on the scope, we can put this picture URL variable, and we can use a placeholder image to start with. There's this very useful service called placehold.it where you can pass any size and it will automatically generate a dynamic image for you like that. And we can change the style a little bit by declaring this item to be an item image, so it will display only the image and resize that automatically. Finally, we want a button so that we can click the button and take a picture. So let's start by adding some padding, and inside we can have our button, and let's add some styling. So the Ionic button class and button block, and then maybe use button calm and say take picture and close the button. So that's our button showing. And we want an action, so when you click the button, we want to take a picture. ng-click, and we will add a function called takePicture that we can add to our controller right now. So on the scope, we add takePicture, that is a function. And what do we need to do here? Well, now we need to go and add the camera plugin. So let's go back to our ng-cordova documentation, and you can see that it suggests adding the Cordova plugin camera. So that's what we're going to do. Let's go to our terminal and quit the Ionic serve process, and then type Ionic plugin add and the full name of the plugin. You can see that all Cordova plugins start with cordova-plugin- and then the name of the plugin. So that's installed now, and let's go back to our documentation. It says here that the camera API only works on a real device and not in the emulator, but this is not actually true. The Android emulator has the ability to emulate the camera as well, and that's exactly what I'm going to use for this example. Let me show you how to use this virtual camera in the Android emulator. If you have the Android SDK installed, you can manage AVDs by typing Android AVD, where AVD is an Android virtual device. And when you create a new device, you need to type a name and then select a device and so on. But you can also select the option for the camera. So rather than none, you can set it to emulate it. That means it will generate some random images, or webcam if you have one. So you can take pictures from your webcam. And that's what I'm going to use. You can also check that this is working by launching the emulator by hand by typing emulator-avd and the image name. Then in my case is Android 5.1 480 by 800. Once the emulator is running, we can check if the camera is working by using the default camera app. And if it's working, you should see my face on the camera. So that's working. Right, good. So we can use this to test our application. And first of all, we need to add Android support because I haven't done this yet. So Ionic platform add Android. And then we can launch our app by typing Ionic emulate Android, and we can use live reload with -l and also show the console logs with C. So we can now develop in Android. We don't need the browser anymore because the camera plugin won't work there. Now let's go back to our documentation and see how we can use this Cordova Camera service. There is a getPicture method that accepts some options, and as an example here, so we can call getPicture with the options, and then we can pass some callbacks receiving the data or possibly an error. So let's see how we can use this in our application. First of all, we need to inject this Cordova Camera service into our controller function, and then we can call Cordova Camera dot get picture and pass some options. I'll just pass some empty options so it will use the defaults. And then we can pass a callback that receives the result, and optionally we can also get an error. So let's handle that case as well. And to start with, we can just log whatever we get so we can see what the result object is. So I'm going to say camera data is, and then convert this to JSON because I'm not sure what kind of object it will be. And then we can do the same thing if there's an error, so we can debug in case of errors. And if we save this and then we go and take a picture, you can see my face there, so I can take a picture of that and confirm, and this should log something into the console. So you can see it says camera data is a file URL. We could try displaying this URL directly as the image source, but that won't work because local file URLs are disallowed for security reasons. So there's an easier way to handle image data, and that's in this example as well. Among the options we can pass is this destination type, and if we set it to data URL, we'll get the image data as base64 encoded data, so we can then display this in this format as the image source. And we also need to specify the encoding type to make sure that we pass the same type in the data URL. So let's try that. We need two options that are destination type and encoding type. So let's create a options variable. Let's create an empty options and set this with destination type data URL, and we don't really care about these two options, and then encoding type JPEG, and then pass these as the options. If you go back to the documentation, we can copy this data URL and use this for our image source. So on success, we set scope.pictureURL to be this data URL plus the encoded data for the image. Let's see if this works. Let's take a new picture and we take this like that and confirm. And you can see the picture on screen. And if you look at the logs, we should see the image data in base64 format. That's a very long string. So that's a simple example using the camera plugin. You can find out what all the other options mean by looking at this documentation. For example, you can specify the image size, or you can let the user choose an existing image from the gallery rather than taking a new picture, and so on. Also, the object returned by getPicture is a promise, and that's something that is frequently used in AngularJS when dealing with asynchronous tasks. You can find out more about promises, if you like, by looking at the documentation for the queue service in AngularJS. I'm not quite sure why it's called queue, but it's the service used to create promises, and that's what ngCordova does as well. So that's it for this lecture, and I'll see you later.